Studies show terminally ill patients are happier when their end-of-life wishes are known and honored. Their medical bills are also cheaper.
Researchers at UCLA found that medical costs are lower and care is better when a plan is in place. Their study found 30% of Medicare dollars are spent on the 5% of beneficiaries who die each year. And one-third of the costs during that last year come during the final month of life. Earlier studies show patients with specific end-of-life plans can reduce health costs in the last week by 36%. And one document in Iowa can make that plan easier to make. KCRG TV9's Dave Fransman joins us now to talk about the iPost form, is what it's called. And Dave, it's supposed to make a patient's end-of-life choices clearer, right?
Well, Beth and Bruce, that's correct. iPost actually stands for Iowa Physician Orders for Scope of Treatment. Now, that's a wordy title, but the distinctive colored document here is important for this. It can spell out exactly what a patient or family wishes done in an acute medical emergency. The idea? Eliminate the guesswork both for the family and medical providers.
Interpretation all along the path.
And this is usually filed in a file.
Kim Lusting and her mother, Virginia Peterson, had never heard of an iPost form until last Friday. But after some serious medical complications and a recent surgery, counselors here thought a goal of care conversation was something the family needed. Filling out the form gave both some peace of mind.
It's already stated, it's marked off. They can refer to it, I can refer to it, and we can move ahead with what she wants.
Very comforting. Not only for myself, but for the kids.
The iPost form asks if a patient wishes resuscitation in the event breathing stops, but it goes farther, specifying the type of treatment, such as comfort only, or mechanical means like ventilators to preserve life. If the patient leaves treatment at one facility, the form goes along as a permanent medical record. It's also not just intended for those with an official diagnosis of a terminal condition.
This is also designed for the frail and elderly. I may be 90 years old and have 5 or 10 more years to live, but if my heart and breathing stopped, I may want to have a natural death and not have you perform CPR.
Harlander says Lynn and Jones counties tested the form beginning in 2008, and it was recognized by state law last year. But it's still a work in progress until medical providers statewide learn how to use it.
About 2,000 patients have filled out those iPost forms in both Lynn and Jones County since the testing began in 2008. Supporters say within another 6 months, probably every medical provider statewide should have received training how to apply the iPost wishes in a medical crisis. Incidentally, the form is not something you can get yourself and fill out. It has to come from and be explained by a medical provider.
Because it's a legal document.
It's a legal document.
Thank you, Dave.